Okay, let's go. Oof. Let's do this. Mayhem 10, test version. I got my beer. We got a 2v2 lined up. Looks like more than 2v2, but there's a couple of watchers in this game. Cool, so let's speed it up. Let's get this spaghetti stuff out of the way. In the red we have Chowie, aka Pepperoni, from the FFAX clan, possibly. Has been around a while, possibly the most experienced player in the game. Over here is Poseidon, who's a young fellow and a bit of a Mayhem fan. Had him playing Mayhem for a few years. He's saying hi. That's good. Up here we have Magpie and the Black on the North team, along with myself over here in the blue. So each team is an arm and a core. It's not an arm versus core. Magpie starting off with air. This map is a crazy map. It's about as close to a metal map as you can get, with very large metal deposit areas, metal plating where you can build a whole lot of metal extractors instead of little spots. Isolated. As you can see, Poseidon starts with K-Bot and so does Chowie. I'm the only one who started with vehicle. Poseidon going T2 straight away, because this is a really high resource map and you can do that. Whereas I've gone second vehicle plant, and my pie is guiding out a bunch of construction vehicles as well, and I'm going tier 2 as well. Chowie getting in early with a bunch of flashes and rockers. Magpie assisting my tier 2 plant for some reason with his own construction. Poseidon going straight into tier 2 extractors. Oh, bit of action. Chowie managed to sneak past my blob of Samsons. see how I basically chose the lazy route by just blobbing up a whole lot of Samsons, which mean any early attack that they did would get shut down. Magpie's chasing down Chowie's rockers. Magpie asked for a con for me, which I gave him, and he decided to try and build metal extractors with it. I would have wanted units, but I want units with them. So I'm getting going into tier 3. And looks like I was the first to start a tier 3 lab. Yeah. But I think actually Poseidon finishes his tier 3 first. Like Poseidon's well ahead at this point. He really ramped up quickly. Yeah, because he's got Mohos in his base here, and Mohos over here, and he's got Mohos over here. And he's got Mortys up too. Which are very effective. A good maneuver there from Poseidon, protecting his Mortys with his storms. Whereas I'm just sitting there blobbing up lots of units and not doing anything with them. I'm really good at doing that. That's my that's probably my secret skill. See, whereas Magpie has sat back a bit, I was really interested in just going as deep as I could. Oh, we did about the same, really. And Poseidon's Mortys did a really good job of defending there. Along with the Centurion short-range missile silos that really polished off my, along with a couple of penetrators, polished off my attack. and left a whole lot of wrecks, but the thing is on this map, wrecks don't really matter so much. There's so much metal available. Okay, in the meantime, I've got a Bertha. Oh, they really are excellent value in terms of long range attack. So Magpie said tier 3 warning. Yes, you can see Poseidon's got a whole lot of construction aircraft and he's building tier 3 there. He's got a gantry up. And but I've got Berthas. Obviously that attack was a response to my Berthas shelling their base. I could have been pushing in that tier 3 a lot more than I was at this point. Oh yes, here's my other special skill. I share this skill with Postal, definitely, in idling cons and building lots of cons and doing nothing with them. I'm busy trying to push up resources here at the moment. How is the resource game looking? Very hard to tell. With sharing turned on, it's very hard to tell. See, Pepperoni is definitely doing the lion's share of the killing at the moment. That'll be thanks to the penetrators, which I see and, of course, destroy with Berthas. Yes. Three Berthas up. Awesome. So what you can see there is Magpie is just sitting in a whole lot of level 1 spam and therefore is the winning at the dying game. It's ticking up so fast. I love these games, they're just absolutely crazy. Oh yes, Poseidon nuked me at this point. He's got a nuke up, which was a really good idea. He's not guarding his tier 3 at the moment, which is rather interesting. I think my building of birth has caused their strategy to change. Bit of a push. Oh. At this point I think it's a bit of a mad rush and people are choosing carefully where they put their attention. I think at this stage I was choking on energy because I was trying to shell away with the birthers. And so busy building fusions in the back there. It's funny how we've kind of both kind of abandoned our original start areas. I see Poseidon's got that great skill of idling a whole lot of cons as well. Quite often the case when you've got a crazy resource battle, you just end up building too many cons and then don't know what to do with them. Except of course with aircraft, because the aircraft can just go over the top of each other and everything guard one factory or a building project at the same time. Joey has so much defenses going on here. He's built lots of arch guns. is something I need to fix. It's being able to put four geos on one vent. There we go, I've got the extinguisher up and going. Is all making very good use of what metal we've got. We've got lots of metal, but we're using it. Nobody has any metal. Nightmare going, Magpie says. Oh yes. Nightmare not going. Yeah, the thing about the nightmare and the extinguisher is you can see where the shot comes from out of the fog of war, so it's easy to spot. Turn to rubble. Less than rubble. It's gone. Oh yeah, at that point I cleaned out a whole row of arch guns, but there was another row behind it. Scouting breaking through. The thing I didn't do was build enough anti-air. And at this point, yes, I think I'm also choking on energy. Oh no, I'm not. No, I'm not. I built a Vulcan and not really making use of it. Good job. Oh, let's see how this nuclear bomber goes. Oh! Right, because of my... because of my tier 4 anti-air here, it didn't do very well. Interesting. I'm now watching my own Vulcan in the game and realizing I really squandered it. There we go. Oh, yes, it's firing. Vulcans and Berthas and buzzsaws all going at each other. And at this point, Magpie has a whole lot of tier 3 going. Nice. And with a construction aircraft that Magpie kindly gave me, I started building Krogoths. What's going on? here's where I start making use of the Vulcan. Okay, here come the scouts. Oh, so much going on. Yep, so that's what happens when you don't have enough anti-air. Everything gets evaporated. Everything. So at this point I think I actually step it up a little bit. You can see, like, yeah, Magpie has a whole lot of factories here, but if you guard them, you get a lot more out of them. Tier 3 versus Tier 3. Yeah, that exposed Scrog didn't really stand a chance. Oh yes, finally make use of some of the blades I have. Somewhat. Not so much. So resurrect one Bertha. Berthas can be incredibly useful for pinpointing little blobs of units like this one here. There we go. All gone. Oh, that was the G2 though. And their G2's gone. Everything dies. One thing to be sure about in a game like this. Everything dies. In this potboiler of a choke point here. Yep, with Pepperoni now winning with both the killing and the dying. That's me saying don't reclaim that wreck because I think it's an extinguisher or something. I wanted to resurrect it. Magpie making up the deficit in anti-air with a couple of screamers. Yes, he did decide to build some armed stuff here. There goes my extinguisher. Vulcan is up. Buzzsaw is idle though. So Poseidon did the same thing with his buzzsaw that I was doing. I saw the Vulcan, so I tried to come in. I sent a bunch of blades in to get confused and die. There we go. Nope, still not dead. Nope. Look at all the constructions coming in to repair it. But at this point I seem to have overrun Pepperoni's troops. So the Vulcan is now somewhat exposed. Oh, I see. I was trying to shoot the one behind it. That didn't work very well, did it? So really, at this point, we've got Poseidon and Chowie really on the back foot. Units like well over into their base, which is ridiculous. They've got so many construction units, but I think this is down to Chowie not really knowing the mod that well and didn't have that much tier 3 going, and Poseidon being just rusty. He hasn't played in a while. This lovely tier 3 air though. Until that Drake was really bothering Magpie. I think what was doing most of the killing is actually the Vulcan. Speed it up a bit. It's Vulcan's firing on nothing. They might be trying to aim at the aircraft. It does take out some stuff. Oh, that was a nuclear cannon. Yes, he has a nuclear cannon up. Here I have enough blades and tier 3 air to completely erase. So that's Chowie done. And then Magpie with just relentless pressure. Poseidon building a wall of flak to try and avoid that happening to his lovely nuclear cannon there. But he would have done better if he had he probably has the buzzsaw on hold fire. If that was actually going, this would be all gone. It's at zero health, but not because it's being repaired by bajillion construction vehicles and K-bots and necros. And eventually it goes down. There we go. Yep. And once the nuclear cannon is gone, Poseidon admits defeat and the game is over. Gosh. What a game. Well, that was fun. I hope you enjoyed that and the intense non-stop explosions that just became a continuous sound. Whoa. Total Mayhem 10 coming soon. Thanks for watching.